A revolution is a fundamental change in power or organizational structures that takes place in a relatively short period of time. George Grenville was in charge of the British Treasury. He was the Prime Minister at the time of Great Britain and introduced many of the taxes and acts.
Stand up! Stand up for your right! Get up! Stand up!
The Navigation Acts were laws that restricted the colonists in what goods they could produce and who they could sell these goods to. The Navigation Acts were an attempt to stop smuggling and to make money from the colonies. When East India Company was going out of business, Great Britain ordered the Tea Act. This was an act put into action to save the East India Company from going out of business and to get money from the colonists all in one action. The Tea Act required colonists to buy tea from the East India Company. The colonists revolted by not buying tea, and this put Great Britain into great economic turmoil. So the British repealed the act. Samuel Adams was a lead conspirator. He was the one who organized the Boston Tea Party. Adams was one of the main people who fought the British. Colonists organized by Samuel Adams dressed up as Indians. They boarded three British ships carrying tea and tossed the tea overboard. 60 men destroyed 90,000 pounds of tea. The Stamp Act was a tax on all paper products. Pieces of paper needed a stamp on it to prove the owner of the piece of paper had paid the tax. The Sugar Act was a replacement for the Molasses Act. The Act was a tax and it was a way to obtain money from the colonists. James Otis found it unfair that the colonists were being taxed. One of his famous quotes was that no taxation without representation. This means that the taxes were unfair because they didn't have representation in Parliament, yet they were the ones who were getting taxed. The Proclamation Act stopped the colonists from moving westward. The line was the Appalachian Mountains. The Indians were on the west and the colonists on the east. This angered the colonists because it stopped them from access to the Mississippi, which in turn stops them from access to the Gulf of Mexico. This, as well, it stopped them from more fur opportunities. Charles Townshend was in charge of the Townshend Acts. The Townshend Acts included a tax on lead, paper, paint, and glass. Thomas Paine was a motivator. At the whim of Ben Franklin, he wrote the pamphlet called Common Sense, which told colonists to revolt against British rule. He was the man most responsible for the Declaration of Independence.
Stand up! Stand up for your right! Get up! Stand up! Don't give up the fight! Get up! Stand up! Stand up for your right!
British troops were sent to keep the colonists at bay. This resulted in 7 days of the Boston Massacre.
Most people think great God will come from the sky, take away everything and make everybody feel high. But if you know what life is worth, you would look for yours on earth.
these are the main taxes of the Revolutionary War because Britain were taxing the colonists unfairly, and the British were taking the colonists' rights away. The British disobeyed the Magna Carta, their constitution, and did many wrong and illegal things that were unjust and wrong.